Now, after understanding the PDV work or displacement work, let's talk about path function and point function. Let's have a look at this diagram first. Now, this is a diagram with a PV plot, and we can say that we can take a system from state 1 to state 2 through different quasi static processes, and these are three quasi static paths. Let us say this is path A, this is path B, and this is path C. Since the area under the curve, area under each curve would be a different value, so the amount of work involved in each case is not a function of the end states, but it depends upon the process. If I have to find out the work done in going from 1 to 2 via path A, it would be this much area. Okay. If I have to find out the work done in going from 1 to 2 via path B, it would be a different area, that is this area. You can see the areas are different. Alright. If I have to find out the work done in going from 1 to 2 via path C, I can easily show it will be a totally different value because the area under the graph would be different. And this can actually tell you that the values of work done, it does not depend upon the initial state and the final state. Now in this case, the initial and the final states are same for all the three paths. This means the work done does not depend upon these two states. So what does it depend upon? It depends upon the path that a process takes or a path that a process follows. And for this reason, the work is called a path function. It is called a path function. And due to this, the mathematical integral that is going from 1 to 2 dw, this is not equal to W2 minus W1. This would mean this is the value of work at state 2. You cannot find out the work at a particular point. So this is an invalid quantity. So this is true for in the case of work, and that is why we put a bar on top of this. And this is called an imperfect integral. Alright, so in fact this value, this is equal to work from 1 to 2. So this is how you represent an imperfect integral, or sometimes it is also denoted as this 1 to 2, and we have to find out work for that case. Alright, so this was about path function. Now let's discuss about point function. What is a point function? Now if you talk about thermodynamic properties, now with property I mean that it has a definite value at a particular state. So let us say at state 1, the property of pressure would have a value P1 and the property volume would have a value V1. So this is how we can say that the property will have a definite value. So it depends upon the point and not on the path that the system undertakes. So we can say that the thermodynamic properties like pressure, volume and temperature, thermodynamic properties are point functions. Alright, so point functions are those values which depend upon the particular state and not on the path that the system would undertake. So we can say that if there is a change in volume from volume V1 to V2, then this is given as V2 minus V1. That is, we will have a value of volume at state 2 and we would have a value of volume at state 1. This kind of an integral is called a perfect integral. Alright, so this is the difference between a path function and a point function. So work is the path function and all the thermodynamic properties are point functions. So this was a very basic understanding of what this is all about. And if you talk about For a cyclic process, if you talk about a cyclic process, the change in property for a cyclic process, that is dV, it is zero. And even if you take pressure in that case, this will also be zero. And even if you take the temperature change, this will also be zero. So you can say that for a cyclic process, the change in the thermodynamic property is zero. Okay, so after understanding the path and the point function and their values for the cyclic process, now let's move on to find out the PdV work in various quasi-static processes.